A woman who has spent years working in the global pro-life movement shares how she is faithfully living out the feminist dream that is this week's Pro-Life Focus. Catholic author Kate Bryan has spent years working in the world of PR, politics, and the pro-life movement. Now the 30-something-year-old single Catholic woman is releasing her first book called Living the Feminist Dream, a faithful vision for women in the world and the church. To share her firsthand experiences and stories of living in the Catholic Church and the world today, Bryan writes, quote, "Women are incredibly resilient. They have a special capacity to grow new life and cultivate and empower others. Every person has the potential to change the world through their lives, but women have a special gift and power." Living the Feminist Dream is set to be released on November 12th. And joining us now is Kate Bryan, author of Living the Feminist Dream. Kate, congratulations on your book launch, my friend. I first off want to say I've known you for years, and reading your book, there are details about your early life that stunned me. Can you first briefly speak about how you came to understand the fragility of life at a very young age?
Catherine, thank you so much for having me, and thank you for your kind words and for reading my book. I'm so excited to share this book with the world. As you said, I experienced the fragility of human life from a very young age, and it was actually in utero that I first experienced that. I was actually one of a twin. My twin's heart stopped beating. My parents were encouraged to have a DNC, which could have ended my life. Mm-hmm. Thankfully, they chose not to. They fought for my life. I fought as a little unborn baby and was born 10 pounds, 14 ounces. So a gigantic baby. And then throughout my life, there were so many lessons of the fragility of human life. My dad had a tragic head injury when he was 33 years old on his 33rd birthday, almost died. Thankfully, he survived. My brother has a type of autism, so he experienced that. And then when I was 15 years old, my grandfather committed suicide. Mm-hmm. So many things throughout my life, I've experienced the fragility of human life. And it's so important for us to stand up and speak out and to be a witness to life.
Yeah, no, I imagine that was so formative. And about your book, the title is Living the Feminist Dream, and that might sound provocative to some. What does living the feminist dream mean to you as a faithful, practicing Catholic woman?
I wrote an article in the Washington Post, Catherine, a couple of years ago, which I'm sure you remember, and many of your viewers probably read it. And I remember getting feedback from people because it said, I'm a 32-year-old virgin living the feminist dream. And people were shocked by it. How could that be? How could you be living the feminist dream if you chose to live a life of chastity? But for me, it never was provocative. It was always just my life. It was choices I made every single day. I remember being a teenager and making that decision, a commitment to chastity when I was a teenager. And then that's continued throughout my life, making a commitment every single day to that. And to me, chastity is the perfection of love. Mm. We should be perfecting love every single day in all of our relationships, including in our romantic relationships. And to me, it was just so simple. So it was never provocative. It just was me living out my faith, living out my decisions and my beliefs every single day.
And in fact, you write that the Blessed Virgin Mary is really your model for the ultimate empowered woman. Can you speak more about that and Our Lady?
Yes, Our Lady, I feel like when I grew up in the church, I often felt like Our Lady was presented as kind of this meek, genteel, quiet, sat in the corner woman that just kind of followed wherever Jesus went. And to me, especially as I've grown older and gotten to know her and have my own relationship with her and gone to many apparition sites around the world, my eyes have been open that she is fierce. She's fearless. She's a fighter. We look at so many examples. I always think of Our Lady of Guadalupe. Juan Diego is walking up and turns around and opens his cloak, and Our Lady storms onto the cloak, and everybody fell to their knees. And so she is such a witness, such an example of the fierceness, the fearlessness that we as women represent in the world today. And I believe that as Catholic women, as women in general, we have a responsibility to be her example in the world, which means standing up, speaking out, and embracing the woman that we were created to be.
Oh, I love that. We only have a minute left, Kate, but if you had to give one takeaway to viewers about your book, what would that be?
I would say that every single person has a purpose. We all have value. We all have a mission to carry out. And it's up to us to figure out what that is and to live it out every single day. And my shout out to women, and I think everybody in the world, we need to raise women up mm-hmm. and give them a space to speak and look at them just like we look at the Blessed Mother, that they are these beacons of hope and fearlessness and resilience. Women are changing the world every single day, and we have a responsibility to stand up, give them space to speak, and let them stand in their rightful place.
Oh, that's so well said. Well, you are such a light in this world. Thank you for empowering the women around you. Kate Bryan, author of Living the Feminist Dream, a faithful vision for women in the church and the world, set to be released on November 12th. Thank you, Kate.